And an investigation by Channel 4 News into fake jobs being advertised in job centres leads to the government revising its vetting procedures. An investigation by Channel 4 News has revealed that government job centres have been advertising bogus jobs. The companies involved hire people who are sellers on the online auction site eBay, but then they find they become victims of a complex scam. Despite warnings, the Department for Work and Pensions carried on advertising the roles for months. Today it said it has changed its vetting procedures. Our technology correspondent Benjamin Cohen has this exclusive report.
The continued economic gloom has left 2.5 million people unemployed.
And many of them end up here at job centres or on their website. And they expect the roles that they're offered will be legal, decent and honest. But instead, Channel 4 News has discovered that for months, job centres have been suggesting fraudulent roles, where the applicants would be unwittingly helping to scam eBay users out of thousands of pounds and ultimately end up with debt collectors knocking at their door.
I trusted the job centre. I wouldn't trust them again, though.
Victims were lured in by jobs listed on the job centre system for eBay salespeople. The job they get is to list products for sale on eBay using their own existing eBay identity. A buyer wins the auction and pays the lister using PayPal. The lister then pays the company they believe they work for, minus their wage, which is a 10% cut. The company is supposed to send the goods out but never does and vanishes, leaving the seller owing the money to the buyer. This is exactly what happened to this eBay seller, who asked us not to use her real name. eBay and PayPal have refunded the money to her customers and chased her for the money back.
Well, I trusted it because it was on Job Centre, you know, Job Centre's website. But the experience I've had, I'd never ever do again. I wouldn't recommend 6 months of hell just for the sake of seeing a job on a site that you trust.
She was working for a company calling itself Giftland Limited. It even had a website. It's fake, though. You can't buy anything from it. Even after a tip-off, it took the Job Centre 6 weeks to realise that it was a scam company.
The real Giftland is this shop here in East London. They've got nothing to do with the scam and reported that their name was being used to the police. In fact, the only thing they've ever sold on eBay was a teddy bear a few years ago.
We've spoken to people all over the UK who were stung by a string of sham companies, likely to be run by the same criminals, all lured vulnerable victims in through the job centre.
Why would a company want a third party to be doing the advertising on eBay and that party to get 10%? Alarm bells should have been ringing. I'm particularly concerned that actually some people may have been encouraged to apply for these jobs by Job Centre Plus staff themselves, because if people are on benefit, then they have to apply for a certain number of jobs in order to keep their benefit.
Police forces claimed that the true victims were PayPal and eBay, who refunded the buyers, so police didn't follow up the complaints of the victims we've spoken to. But Channel 4 News understands that eBay has picked up the pace, and there is now an active police investigation to work out where all the money has gone.
It's not just pennies we're talking about, it's tax-free, they're getting away with all this money. And someone needs to do something, because they'll just carry on doing it, getting more people in the same boat that I've been in.
eBay and PayPal have suspended the recovery of the money while the police investigate. Since Channel 4 News contacted it and eBay wrote twice in protest, the Department for Work and Pensions has revised its job listings policies. Now it says the job centre must check centrally all jobs that relate to eBay before they go live to see whether they're genuine vacancies or just the latest way to scam innocent victims out of thousands of pounds.